Long ago, when the earth was flat, three tales from Africa. Retold by Paolo Cabraro Luzzatto, illustrated by Amoni Samboy. Long ago, when the earth was flat, three tales from Africa. Retold by Paolo Cabraro Luzzatto, illustrated by Amoni Samboy, designed by Bruno Minari. Contents: long ago when the earth was flat, how the mountains came to be, a tale from Tanzania, a visit from Mr. C, how the sun got into the sky, a tale from Nigeria, and a gift from a star, how people got fire, a tale from Zaire. Long ago when the earth was flat. Long ago the earth was all flat. The sky looked down on her from afar and spoke with her. The earth, however, heard nothing but. The sound of the wind and the thunder, and never understood just what the sky was saying. One day, the earth decided to go up to the sky to hear his voice and answer it. Higher she rose, and higher still, until at last she reached the sky. Nobody knows what they said to each other. But when they had finished talking, the earth said goodbye to the sky and began to make her way back. Then a strange thing happened. Not all the earth came back home. Some parts, in fact, decided to stay close to the sky. They had made friends with the clouds and were unhappy to leave them. These are the parts of the earth that are now called mountains. A visit from Mr. C. Long ago, Mr. Sun lived on the earth in a house near the sea. Mr. Sun and Mr. C were good friends. Mr. Sun often went to call on Mr. C, but Mr. C never returned his visits. I come to see you all the time, but you never visit me. Why not? Mr. Sun asked him, his feelings hurt. The sea answered, "You have no idea how many children I have. Your house is too small for me and all my children." But the son refused to believe him and kept inviting him again and again. Finally, Mr. C decided to accept Mr. Sun's invitation. He knocked at the door of the son's house. "I have come for a visit," he said. "May I come in?" "Yes, of course," the son replied. "May I come in with all my children?" the sea added. "Yes, of course," the son repeated. And so the sea began to come in, with all his waters, all his fish large and small, and his animals, his seaweed and other plants. Soon the water came up to the sun's knees, then to his chin. The sea asked, "May I still come in?" The son did not know what to say. After all, he was the one who had insisted on the visit from the sea. Not knowing what to do, the son decided to climb up on the roof of his house, and he answered, "Yes, yes, come right in." Soon, the waters of the sea also covered the roof of the house, and there was nothing for the sun to do but jump up into the sky. And once he was there, he never came down again. Gift from a star. Long ago, people had no fire. At night, and in the wintertime, they were cold. So they gathered their friends, the animals, and said to them, "We need your help. How can we keep ourselves warm? How can we cook our food?" A spider came up and said, There is fire in the sky, and I will help you reach it. The spider spun a very long thread, then called the wind. "Help me," she said. "We have to reach the sky." The wind came and lifted one end of the thread, carrying it off all the way up to the sky. Then the wind called to the woodpecker. "Please come here and help us," it said. "We have to give the people fire." The woodpecker flew along the thread spun by the spider, stopped at the end, and with his sharp beak began to peck some holes in the lid of the sky, and fire appeared in the form of stars. Then the people chose a strong man to climb the spider's thread. Up and up he climbed until he reached the sky. When he was at the top, he broke off a piece of a star and came down again with it. From then on, people had fire.